Hello, one and all present here. This is Amit Kumar Singh. Welcome back to my session on Reminder Theorem. I hope you are enjoying my sessions. Reminder Theorem is a very important concept. When you talk about any competitive exam, a lot of questions in exam come from Reminder Theorem. When we talk about reminder is a word. We remember these term reminder from our childhood, from the time when we are working on mathematics. So when we talk about reminder, so in reminder, basically we need to understand positive reminder. We need to talk about positive reminder and negative reminder. Okay, so positive reminder we know very well from our childhood. Whenever we solve the problem on maths, we know what is positive reminder is all about. But the time, if I'm using the word called negative reminder, you would be getting confused. Like imagine if I divide a number 2 by 3. Suppose 2 is my dividend and 3 is my divisor. Okay, so what is a positive reminder? Positive reminder would be 2 only. We know that. Or otherwise, what I can do, if I say 3 ones are. So if I take 3 ones are, then what I'll get? Then I'll get a reminder called minus 1. Okay, guys. So when we solve the problem on reminder theorem, along with a reminder plus 1, there's a reminder minus 1 also, which is very which will be very close to your heart if you have definitely solved the problems on reminder. So when we solve the problem on reminders, what we try to do, we try to figure out by hook or crook, by doing permutation or combination. Whatever we try to do, we try to see if we can get a positive reminder or we can get a negative reminder. Something like that. Suppose if I give you this number 13793 to the power 13793. Okay. So if I ask you, okay, divide this number by two. Okay. Tell me the reminder. Okay, divide this number by two. Tell me the reminder. Okay. So what primarily you can do here? So what primarily I can do? I hope you are understanding the power and all, a to the power x. So if you see a number called a to the power x, so I hope you are understanding. You are writing a how many times? You are writing a x times. So this is basically a to the power x. So here, if you see this number and the power is 13793. So if your power is 13793, it means that. It basically means that you are writing that number 13793 to the power 13793 times. Okay, and then you are trying to find the reminder. Okay, you know that the reminder would be 1 only. So if you do anything, so you know that any number you divide like this, you are going to get the reminder 1 only. If this number 13793, if this is your number 13793, if you divide it by 2, what will happen? You know that. The number is 17, you know that this will go by 18, this will be 19. So you know that what is going to happen. So this will be 9, this is 18, 113, this is 6. So you know that your reminder anyway, if you're dividing any number by 2, if that number is an even number, that will be divisible by 2. If that number is odd number, that will give you reminder of 1. So if it doesn't matter how big is this number, it doesn't matter what is that power of that number. So imagine if you write this number 13793 into 13793 into 13793. This number, if you're writing till 13793, if you're dividing this number by 2, every time what you are getting, every time you are getting a reminder 1. So reminder 1, you are getting 13793 times. Doesn't matter, 1 to the power, anything will give you 1 only. So what will the reminder here, guys? The reminder for this problem would be simple, 1 only. So don't get confused when you see big numbers and all. The questions would be very easy, if not at all something you need to use lot of your brain and all. So imagine if your divisor is 10, so the examiner is expecting you to tell you the unit digit. So imagine in place of 2, imagine if the same number 13793. Imagine in place of 2, if I've written a divisor called 10. So what the examiner is expecting you to tell you the unit digit. They are expecting you to tell the unit digit. Everyone, I believe, by this time, you know how to find the unit digit of the number. So how to find the unit digit of the number, and you see that if you see here, this number is ending with 3. If you see here, this number is ending with 3. And you know that for finding the unit digit of the number, if a number is ending with 3, you know that what you will do, you will see the power cycle of 3. Okay, so you just need to break the power in the multiple of 4. Or you can break the power in the multiple of 4. Or simply, if you have seen my video on unit digit, if you have seen my video on divisibility, you know that to divide the number by 4 is better to see the last 2 digits of the number, because that determines the divisibility rule of 4. If you see the last 2 digits of the number, that is 93. 93, if you divide by 4, you will get a remainder 1. So what is 3 to the power 1? So what is 3 to the power 1? 3 to the power 1 is 3. The remainder for this, if you divide by 10, your remainder would be 3. In case if they are asking you, in case in the problem, if they have given you 100, in case in this problem, if they have given you 100, so what they are expecting you, they are expecting you to find the last 2 digits of the number. Okay. So then they are expecting you to find the last 2 digits of the number. How will you find the last 2 digits of the number? I hope you know that how to find the last 3 digits of the number. If this number is 137, 137.93 to the power 137.93, if you divide this number by 100, what they're expecting you to find the last 2 digits of the number. Okay, so how to find the last 2 digits of the number for this? So here to one, so simply focus on 137.93 to the power 137.93. How to find the last 2 digits of the number? For that, you can ignore these digits. These digits won't be significant for you. What is important for the last 2 digits? Only the last, the 10th place and the number. So 93 to the power 137.93. Okay, now you know that 93, it is an odd number. So you'll use the property of odd number for finding the last 3 digits of the number, last 2 digits of the number, because you're dividing by 100. If you divide by 1000, you have to find the last 3 digits. Can you write this number as 93 to the power 4? Okay, so if you write this number to the power 93 to the power 4, so divide this power by 4. So 4 threes are 12. So 1 carry 17. 4 fours are 16. 19. 19 means 4s are 33. 33 means 8s are into 93. Okay, so if you divide it by 4, you will get a remainder called 1. So 3, 4, 4, 8 into 4 plus 1 will be 137.93. Okay, so 12 is 17. 17 means 4s are 19. 19 means 4s are 33. 33 is 8s are. Okay, now what is 93 to the power 4? I don't know what is 93 to the power 4, but I know 93 to the power 2. So what I can do, I can write this number as 93 to the power 2 into 93 to the power 2 to the power 3448 into 93. Okay, what is 93 to the power 2? 93 to the power 2, 93 square is 8649. Okay, doesn't matter. So doesn't matter what is the other digit. I hope everyone understands this, that the k square and 50 minus k square, 50 plus k square, 100 minus k square, 100 plus k square, all will end with the last 2 digit of the k square. All will end with the last 2 digit of k square. So what is the k here? 93 I can write, 100 minus 7. So 100 minus 7 means what is 7 square? What is 7 square? 49. So it will end with 49. So this is nothing but 49 square to the power 3448 into 93. Okay, what is 49 square? 49 square is 2401. So you can write this as 01, last 2 digits. Just focus on the last 2 digits to the power 3448 into 93. Now 1 to the power any number will be 1 only. So what is the last 2 digit of this number? Last 2 digit would be 93. So if you divide this number by 100, what is your remainder? Your remainder would be 93 only. So the idea, I hope you are understanding the idea. So the remainder theorem, the concept of remainder theorem, whatever we have learned, how to find the unit digit of the number, how to find the last 2 digit of the number, all you can apply here when you're solving the problem on remainder theorem. So the problem on remainder theorem are not at all difficult. You can easily solve the problem. Now, the very important thing when you are solving the problem on remainder theorem, the very important thing, what you have to learn the Euler theorem. So Euler theorem. So remainder theorem, you have to learn. Whenever you get a problem, you can easily solve the problem by Euler theorem. So in reminder theorem, Euler theorem is very important to solve the problem. So whenever you get right any problem, you see any problem, you're getting any kind of problem, you can easily solve it with the application of Euler theorem. So suppose 77 to the power 1113 divide by 17. Okay, what is the remainder? If I ask you this problem, what is the remainder? So if you want, you can simplify this number, divide 77 by 17, find the remainder. So 17 threes are 51, 17 fours are 68. So you can write the same number. So 68, 17 fours are 68. So this 77 minus 68 is 9. If you divide 77 by 17, how much you will get? 9. So 9 to the power 1333 divide by 70. You can simplify this number like this way. I hope you're understanding. But think this. So 77 is repeated to 1133 times. Okay. Now you are dividing this number by 17. Where your dividend is 9 to the power 1333, and you're dividing it by 17. You know that 17 is a prime number. So you know that what would be the quotient number? What would be the quotient number of 17? The quotient number of 17 would be 16 only. I hope everyone. What do you mean by quotient number? How we work on Euler theorem? So Euler theorem, we work in such a way, like suppose you're dividing a number A by a number called B. Suppose you're dividing a number A by B, and it has some power. Okay, now in order to work on Euler theorem, A and B should be co-prime to each other. Okay, the first and very important thing, that A and B, that the dividend and divisor, they should be the co-prime to each other. Co-prime means they should have HCF of 1. Okay, now the next thing, once if they are co-prime to each other, you can see here 9 and 17. What is HCF of 9 and 17? That would be 1 only. So once you got to know that they are co-prime to each other, then what you need to do, find the quotient number of divisor. So the quotient number of divisor means you just need to find how many numbers less than 17 are co-prime to 17. You know that because 17 is a prime number, every number which is less than 17 are co-prime to 17. The quotient number of 17 would be 16. Okay, so the quotient number of every prime number, if the prime number is P, then the quotient number of every prime number would be P minus 1. Okay, so what Euler theorem says, that Euler theorem says that if A and B are co-prime to each other, and the quotient number of B is suppose theta, suppose the symbol is theta, then it means that it will give you a remainder called 1. It means that it will give you a remainder called 1. Simple. So here, the proof of this is not the scope of preparation of the exam. So here, 9 divided by 16, so take the power 16. 9 divided by 17, the power would be 16. Why? The quotient number of 17 is 16. Okay, now you can write this in this form. So 1333 divide by 16, if you do. So 16 nines are is 144. 16 eights are is 128. So 128, that would be 16 eights are 128. So 128, it would be 53. 53 means 16 threes are. 16 threes are is 48. 48 means 53 means 5. 48 plus 5, 53. So into 9 to the power 5. Okay, so that is, so you can break 133 in this way. So let me check. 16 threes are 48. 16 eights are 128. This is 8 to 1328. 1328 plus 5 is 1333. Okay, now once you understood, so what I'm telling you, if you apply Euler theorem, you have to understand that if your divisor and dividend are co-prime to each other, you have to find the quotient number of your divisor. So once you find the quotient number of your divisor, so always remember that your dividend to the power of the quotient number, once you divide by the divisor, it will always give you a remainder of 1. So 9 to the power 16, when you divide by 17, will give you remainder 1. So 9 to the power 16, any multiple of you will take, it will give you remainder 1 only. Because 1 to the power anything will give you 1 only. And then into 9 to the power 5. So what left with you? Now this giving you remainder of 1. So 1 into 9 to the power 5 divide by 17. Okay. So now how to do this? 9 to the power 5 is how much? I don't know. How much 9 to the power 5? Okay. So how can I find the remainder of this? Okay. How can I find the remainder of this? Okay, let's do this. So what is 9 to the power 1? 9 to the power 1 is 9. Okay, so if you divide 9 by 17, the remainder is 9. Okay, 9 to the power 2 is how much? 81. 9 to the power 2 is 81. Now 81, if you divide by 17, it's so that it will give you a remainder called minus 4. because 17.5 is 85. So minus 4 means what? 13 plus 4, 17. It will give you remainder called 13. And 9 to the power 3 will be what? See, 9 to the power 3, don't waste your time. 9 to the power 3 is 729. Don't waste your time in finding 729 divided by 17 is how much remainder and all. Oh my God, please don't do all that. Okay. What you simply do, you know that this is 9 to the power 1. This is 9 to the power 2. It is giving you remainder 9. It is giving you remainder called 13. What is 13 nines are? 117. So 117. Okay. So now 117 means what? 117 means what? You know that 17 sevens are 119. So it will give you remainder minus 2. Minus 2 means what? 15 remainder. Okay, this is 729. If you want, we can do that. So 729. If you divide by 17, 17 fours are 68. So you're getting 49. 49 means 2s are 34. You're getting a remainder by 15. Simple. Now, if I ask you 9 to the power 4, 9 to the power 4 is how much? 81 square. That is 6561. So don't do anything. You know 9 to the power 3? 9 to the power 3 is how much? 15. Okay, what is 9 to the power 1? 9. 15 nines are is how much? 135. Divide 135. Divide 135. 59 divide 135 by 7. 135 by 17. Sorry, 135 by 17. Now, what is 17 sevens are? 119. 17 sevens are is 119. What is 17 eights are? What is 17 eights are? 17. What is 17 eights are? So, 17 eights are is 136. So, it is giving you remainder card minus 1. Minus 1 means what? Minus 1 means 16 remainder. Okay, if I take 9 to the power 1, better you can write minus 1 also. 9 to the power 5, what is 9 to the power 5? I don't know. Okay, but what 9 to the power 5, can I say 9 to the power 4 into 9 to the power 1? That is minus 1 into 9, minus 9. Minus 9 means what? Minus 9 means what? 17 minus 9 is how much? 17 minus 9 is 8. Your remainder would be 8. That's it. So your remainder here in this problem, for this problem, your remainder would be 8. Simple. I hope you understood the concept. So when we talked about Euler theorem, so what we basically do in Euler theorem, understand something. I'll take composite number. I don't think prime number you'll understand properly. Maybe some number 8943 to the power 728 something divide by what number should I take? Divide by suppose something should I take 15 or 2 square 14. Okay, let's take 12. Okay. If you divide it by 12, okay. Let's take a number like 12. Okay, let's divide it by 12. What is the remainder? So what is 12? What is 12? 12 is 2 square into 3. What is 12? 12 is 2 square into 3. So what is the quotient number of 12? So the quotient number of 12 would be 12 into 1 minus 1 by 2 into 1 minus 1 by 3. Okay, so what is the quotient number of 12? 12 into 1 by 2 into 2 by 3. Okay, so what is the quotient number of 12 you will get? You will get 4. So, sir, what you are doing, sir? What is the quotient number and all? So, in quotient number of 12 is 4. So, what that means? It means you have to find all the numbers less than 12 which are co-prime to 12. So, what are those numbers? So, co-prime to 12, because 12 is the even number, so none of the even number can be co-prime to 12. Okay. What? How many numbers are co-prime to 12? 1, 5, okay, then 7, okay, then 11. These are the 4 numbers. Either manually you do that or remember this way. So if you express the number, if you express a number like this, a to the power p into b to the power q into c to the power r or d to the power s. So here I'm not going to teach you finding the number of factors and all, okay. So what is the quotient number of this? So the quotient number of this would be n, the n into 1 minus 1 by a. Here the power doesn't matter. Into 1 minus 1 by b, into 1 minus 1 by c, into 1 minus 1 by d, like this. Okay. So the quotient number of 12 is 4. So what that means? That means 8943 to the power 4. If you divide it by 12, you'll get a remainder 1. Okay, now if you see this number, this is 1za, this is 1za, this is 32. 32 means 8za, then 2za. So it's completely divisible. It is completely divisible by 4. Okay, so it's a power factor of 4. So what remainder it will give you? It will give you remainder of 1. Okay, it will give you a reminder of one only. Okay, so simple problem. So I hope you understood the concept of Euler. So the Euler theorem is very important. Now, going further on Euler theorem. So as you understood the Euler theorem, now next thing to understand is the Fermat-Little theorem. So the next theorem to understand is the Fermat-Little theorem. So what is Fermat-Little theorem? Fermat-Little theorem says that if you divide any dividend by a divisor, the divisor is prime number. So you know that if you divide any number by the prime number, then the quotient number of that prime number would be p minus 1. So this will give you a reminder, hal 1. So already whatever those who understand Euler theorem, they can understand this very well. So this is a Fermat-Little theorem. Okay, simple. Now there's some books also write it like this. So this a to the power p by p means where p is your prime number. So that will give you a reminder, hal a. Simple thing. Those who understand this, they can easily understand this. Okay, so a to the power p, you can write a to the power p as a to the power p minus 1 into a. Okay, so where p is your prime number? Where p is the prime number? What are the properties of prime number? I hope you remember the properties of prime number. That every prime number except 2 and 3, when they are divided by 6, they will either give you a remainder called plus 1 or minus 1. Okay, so everyone understand the properties of prime. What are prime number? There are 25 prime numbers are there from 1 to 100. 21 prime numbers are there from 100 to 200. Okay, everyone understand the largest 3-digit prime number is 997. The smallest 4-digit prime number is 1009. All this you should have in your mind that will serve the objective. So anyone have any doubt, you can easily understand. Whatever the Fermat-Little theorem is nothing but it's an extension of or it's a derivation of Euler theorem. Okay, now going further, now let's talk about Wilson theorem. So once you understand the Fermat-Little theorem, let's talk about Wilson theorem. So Wilson theorem is not something very difficult. It's the same thing whatever we have studied till now. So the Wilson theorem is like not so common also. So you just need to keep Wilson theorem in mind. So remember, if this p is your prime number, so p minus 1 factorial divide by p will give you a remainder. Will give you a remainder called p minus 1. This is the Wilson theorem. Means suppose take a prime number. Maybe suppose a prime number is 7. So if I divide 6 factorial by 7, then my remainder will be 6. You want to prove, you can prove 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 divided by 7. Or simple, what is 6 factorial? Why I am doing all that? What is 6 factorial? 720. 720 if you divide by 7. 720 if you divide by 7. So how much? 7, 1 is 7, then 20. So 20 if you divide, you will get the remainder called 6. Okay, so hope you understood this. Okay, now, so this is called Wilson theorem. So this is called Wilson theorem, and one more part of the Wilson theorem is like p minus 2 factorial divided by p, you will get a remainder called 1. P minus 2 factorial, if you divide it by p, you will get a remainder called 1. So here if your prime number is 7, so if you take p minus 2 means 5 factorial. So 5 factorial by 7, it will give you a remainder called 1 only. Okay. So hopefully now going maybe suppose if 10 factorial by 11, I want to prove it. So I want to find 10 factorial by 11. I want to see the derivation. So what is the 10 factorial value if I want to do? So 10 factorial is 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2. This I'll divide by 11. What is my remainder? So if I'm dividing by 11, so I have to find the value of this. So if I divide this by 11, what is the remainder I should get? So as per what we have learned, so if 10 factorial should, if you divide by 11, what remainder you should get? You should get a remainder called 10. It means, what that means? That means this number should be divisible by 11. Okay. So you want to you really want to multiply and then check? No, let's figure out something else. Let's figure out something else. Is this number divisible by 11 or something? Let's figure out something this. So 9 8s are 72. So 9 8s are, if you want to multiply, you can figure out by other way. So 9 8s are 72. 72, if you divide by 11, you get a remainder called 6. Okay, you get a remainder called 6. Okay, now what is 7 factorial? 7 factorial, what is 7 factorial? That is 5040. So 5040, if you divide by 11, what is the remainder? This is 4s are 44. So this is 64. 64 means 5s are 55. 55 means 90. Means 8s are, that will give you a remainder called 2. So this is giving you a remainder called 2. This is giving you a remainder called 2. Now the 6 2s are 12. 12 divided by 11. 6 2s are 12. This is 7 factorial. No? This is 7 factorial. 7 factorial if you divide by 11. 7 factorial is 5040. Okay, 5 factorial is 123, 6 factorial is 720, 7 factorial is 5040, 8 factorial would be 40320. So if you want to check, you can check by like this. So 6 2s is 12. 12 into 10 is 120. Okay, so you can divide by 11. So 6 2s are 12. 12 if you divide by 11, how much you are getting? 12 if you divide by 11, how much you will get? So that you will get a remainder 1. Okay, so 1 into 10, what you will get the remainder? You will get a remainder called 10 only. Okay, so see this number, it's very easy number. So you take the number, you divide it by like this way, you're going to get the same answer. You don't have to worry on looking at the numbers. You don't have to worry on looking at the number. So you can prove it like that way. So other way, 10 factorial is 3628800. If you divide this number by 11, so 3628800. If you divide by 11, you'll get 33. That is 32. This is 2za. This is 2za. You'll get 22. This is 10. 108. 108 means 9za. So 108. 11 9s are 99, 11 10s are 110. So this, you take 9s, you'll get 98. So you'll get 98. Then you take 8s, you'll get 88. So you'll get 100. You'll get 100. So you'll take 99. Then 9s, you'll get 10. So the final remainder is 10. So to understand this is very easy. So 10 factorial, if I divide by 11, what would be your remainder? Your remainder would be 10. So if you take 9 factorial divided by 11, the remainder will be 1. You can prove it. So 9 factorial is 368000. If you divide, you'll get a remainder 1. Here remove 10, you get a remainder 1. Okay, simple concept. So this is called Wilson theorem. So we have learned about Euler theorem. We have learned about Fermat-Little theorem. We have learned about Wilson theorem. Now let's talk about Chinese remainder theorem. Chinese remainder theorem is very easy. Let's talk about Chinese remainder theorem. The Chinese remainder theorem is very easy. So like Chinese remainder theorem, we normally use when your divisor is very big. So here your divisor is 77. So if you see your dividend is 2 to the power 100. This you are dividing by 77. So what we do in Chinese remainder theorem, we break our divisor. Okay, I'll break my divisor. So 77, I broke in two parts, 7 and 11. Okay, now what I will do, now I'll find the remainder when 2 to the power 100 divide by 7. And then I'll find the remainder when 2 to the power 100 divide by 11. Okay, so and then I'll figure out the remainder on that. So what I'll do, now I'll divide my exercise into two parts. Well, first I'll do 2 to the power 100 divided by 7. What is my remainder? I'll find 2 to the power 100 divided by 11. What is my remainder? Okay, so you can apply a Euler theorem. 7 is a prime number, so the quotient number of 7 would be 6. You can write 2 to the power 6 by 7. So 16 6za is 96 into 2 to the power 4. So 2 to the power 6, if you divide by 7, you get a remainder 1. So now 2 to the power 4 is what? 16. 16, if you divide by 7, what is your remainder? Your remainder would be 2. Okay. Now same thing I'll do for 11. 11 again is a prime number. So what is the quotient number of 11? 10. So 2 to the power 10. If you divide by 11, what will be your remainder? Your remainder would be 1. So 2 to the power 10. So 1 to the power n number, what will be remainder? Your remainder will be 1. Okay. So now simple. So what you understood till now? So you understood that when my divisor was 7, my remainder is 2. When my divisor was 7, then my remainder is 2. Okay. And then when my divisor is 11, then my remainder is 1. So you just need to find this. Okay. So can I write this in this form? Okay. Let's do this mathematical homework. Let's write this number as 11k plus 1 and divide this number by 7. And keep finding the value of k till the time you don't get the remainder called 2. Because when you divide the number, you should get a remainder called 2. Okay, let's start put the value of k. Let k is 0. If k is 0, then your number is 1. 1 divided by 7, remainder is 1. Okay, let's put k 1. If k is 1, then your number is 12. 12 divided by 7, remainder is 5. Let's put k as 2. K is 2 means 23. Your number is 23. 23 divided by 7, your remainder is 2. Means your work is done. What is your number? Your number is 23. So what is the remainder you will get here? So the remainder for this problem. So the remainder for this problem is 23. This is your answer. Simple. Okay, let's do one more problem. Like suppose your problem is like this. Okay, 11 to the power 100 divided by 105. What is your remainder? Okay. So can I break 105 means what? 5 into 21. I can break this as 3 into 5 into 7. Can I do this? 35 threes are 105. Okay, fine. So I can break this number as 3 into 5 into 7. So I can write this as 11 to the power 100 divided by 105. So that is nothing but 11 to the power 100 divided by 3 into 5 into 7. Okay. So now I'll separate my work into three parts. So 11 divided to the power 100 divided by 3. Tell me the remainder. Now 11 to the power 100 divided by 5. Tell me the remainder. Now 11 to the power 100 divided by 7. Tell me the remainder. Let's do this exercise. So you know the quotient number of 3 would be 2. So 11 to the power 2 by 3. So this is 50. So your remainder would be 1 only. Very simple. Okay. I hope till now you understood this. Now the quotient number of 5 would be 4. Yeah, this is a prime number. Divide by 5, so your remainder would be 1 only. So now here, in case of 7, the quotient number of 7 is 6. Okay, so this is to the power 6 into 11 to the power 4 divide by 7. Okay, now this part is 1. Now 11 to the power 4. What is 11 to the power 4? What is 11 to the power 4? Means 121 square. Okay, so 11. Can I write 11 as, if you divide 11 by 7, what remainder you will get? 7 ones are 7 means 4 remainder. So you mean 4 to the power 4 by 7. Okay, 4 to the power 4 by 7. Okay, so 4 to the power 4. So 4 to the power 1 is 4. 4 to the power, what is 4 to the power 4? It's 256. No? 4 to the power 4 is what? 256, 16 square, 256. 256, if you divide by 7, what is the 7? 3s are 21. So you'll get 46, 7, 6 are 42. You'll get a remainder called 4. Okay, so 4 to the power 4. 4 to the power 4 is 256. So 256, if you divide by 7, 7, 3s are 21. So this is 46, 7, 6 are 42. You get a remainder called 4. So means what? So when you divide it by 3, you get a remainder 1. When you divide it by 5, you get a remainder 1. But when you're dividing by 7, you're getting a remainder called 4. You have to find that number. Okay, let's use your brain. Let's think. So when your divisor is 3, your remainder is 1. When your divisor is 5, your remainder is 1. When your divisor is 7, your remainder is 4. Okay. Okay. So let's write the number as 7k plus 4. Let's write the number as 7k plus 4. Now start putting the value of k. We'll stop when we'll get a remainder 1 with 3 and 5. So let k is 0. If k is 0, then the number is 4. 4 divided by 3 is 1. But 4 divided by 5 is 4. So it's not giving you remainder 1 in both 3 and 5. Okay. Now, now k value 1. K value 1, if I put, then the number is 11. 11 divided by 3 is what? 2. Remainder 2. Now, with 5, it will give 1. So also, the k1 does not work. Let's put k2. If k is 2, then your number is k2. Means k is 2. Means your number is 18. 18 divided by 3 is remainder 0. Not possible only. Okay, put K3. If you put K3, then your number is 25. Then it's not giving you remainder 1 with 5. Okay, leave it. So put K4. If you put K4, your number is 32. So 32 also will not give a remainder 1 with 5. Okay, leave it. So you put K5. If you put K5, your number becomes 39. 39 is divisible by 3. It's not giving remainder 1. Leave it. So put K6. If you put K6, your number is 46. 46 na 7, 6 are 42, 46. 46. 46 is giving you remainder 1 with both 3 and 5. So 46, if you put K is equal to 6, if you put K equal to 6, so 7, 6 are 42. 42 plus 4, 46. 46, when you divide by 3, so you're getting a remainder 1. 15, 3 are 45, you're getting a remainder 1. 46, when you're dividing by 5, you're getting a remainder 1. So what is the remainder here? What is your remainder here? So in this problem, what is your remainder here? 46. Huh? You get an answer called 46. So this is a number. So your reminder in this problem is 46. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this session, guys. So what we have done in reminder theorem in this session, we have studied about Euler theorem, we have studied about Fermat-Littell theorem, we have studied about Wilson theorem, we have studied about Chinese remainder theorem. So guys, I hope you enjoyed this session. Remainder theorem is a very important concept when you talk about any competitive exam. A lot of questions in exam come from remainder theorem. So I hope you enjoyed this session. Thank you everyone. God bless you.
Thank you for watching this video. You should definitely watch the next video. Link in description.